Well, hi. Welcome aboard this drive to Sibonga. We are leaving the mountain resort. An interesting access road here. Just a little bit of turbulence, as Rowan would say, because he loves aircraft. And we're making our way towards the main road. We are about to turn onto Ilaya Road, which runs from Ronda down to Argao. Please excuse my pronunciation. Oh, what's this idiot doing? He's driving on the left. Whee! Ah, that's better. Good boy. Now we're settling down into the journey and making our way along here. I perhaps ought to give you some idea of how I have selected the clips. There's half an hour's worth of video here. The journey that we're doing, I think took well over an hour and 10 minutes. Basically, I've tried to capture a sense of when we're in the mountains. I have tried to capture the sense of the pleasure of driving along these gently twisting roads. And I've also tried to capture, but not all of them by any means, the little places, some of them bigger places that we go through. There's not enough here to identify each of them. I could not name them. But maybe, if you're local, you'll recognize some of them. Good luck. Where'd he come from? Huh? Where'd he come from? I sort of pride myself usually on scanning the mirrors and knowing what's where and what's behind me. I must admit this road somewhat seduced me into thinking this is a nice drive all on our own. And this booger appears. And to me, driving much too quick. So I'm going, must be a local. Oh well, see you later. I wonder what he's up to. He's definitely traveling a lot slower than he was before. What you've missed is him stopping and stop. Ah! He's thinking, can I squeeze through there? You can tell I'm not impressed by this guy's driving at all. Well, I had been thinking that this was quite a good road, given that it was a back road. I suppose I would regard it as something like a British B road. The way it's marked on a map, a C-class road in the UK. Which you would expect to be fairly awful in the Philippines. But no, we're doing okay. But just wait and see. Will it last? Oh no, it won't last. There you are. Another rough bit. And another rough bit. And. Yep. More rough bits. And every time you see one of those red things, you're going. Anyway, up this bump. Hey, and I think we're on our way now. Oh, who's this? Do you recognize it? Blah. Yeah, Daddy definitely feeling calmer now. We're going through these little villages and round these little bends. Not seeing so much signs of broken road. Happy Daddy. So I'm beginning to think about where we turn. Ooh. Oh, this is really good, isn't it? He's a very, very nice garage. Maybe, perhaps. And the road outside is absolutely rotten. And we're coming to a bridge. But I'm thinking about where we're going to turn off. I'm quite excited. We're going to travel down the vegetable highway. Flying vegetables anywhere, perhaps? Turn the microphone on. Well, now, the vegetable highway. In one sense, it's obvious why it's called the vegetable highway, because they move vegetables along it. But it's just my stupid sense of humour, I think. I have this image of flying vegetables high up along the mountain, or at least along the little ridges. Anyway, we'll see what it's like, the vegetable highway. Feeling less impressed by the quality of the vegetable highway. We've had quite a few bits of missing road so far. how the roadworks are beginning to feel a bit extreme. We have a few kilometres like this. My guess is that the lorries, the vehicles carrying vegetables, actually go out through our gao rather than the way that we're going. As you can see, this is not pleasant drive. And also with the amount of weed that's showing along the concrete, it's not been attended to for a while. Increase in motorbikes. Are we getting near some kind of civilization? I ask myself. Oh, this is not happy driving. Definitely not happy driving. Look, 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 we're coming to a junction. And maybe a better road. Yep. We're on our way. Motorbikes. Yeah, this looks better. Happier, happier daddy. So it becomes clear that we are arriving somewhere. Oh yes. Soon it will be time to say goodbye and thank you very much for driving with us. We do hope you enjoyed your trip and you will drive with us again. Yep, it's a surfeit of airline simulators from my number one boy, my son, the Gugu. Sorry if it irritates you as much as it irritates me. Oh, but here we are. We're parking up. The girls are going to do some shopping. And then we're going to make our way up to Winayagan. Through that terrible place called Kaka. Take care. Bye-bye.